has probably played a good bit over the week. They both rock Pika for the most part, both solid Pikas. So let's see how the West Coast matches up against the Midwest here. We were actually all in the same pools, and I don't know who won in boss battle. So let's see who can do it today. It's a new weekend.
That it is. I think Beef will generally be favored here. Beef having a lot of highs and lows as a player.
He's had a good year, though.
Oh, definitely. He had such a great Smash and Clash run. I think getting fifth place there.
Yeah, I got top eight there.
And a little early on that forward smash, but just ready for that option coverage using that jab grab.
Mustacher lets him back, and this could be a big opening for Beef. Mustacher off stage. Oh, no edge cancel.
Oh, and Beef was ready. Really waiting it out.
That's like, it's a good tool from Pika, but it's very easy to let it become a bad habit. And a lot of us Pikas at the low to mid-high levels all kind of try to abuse that up air from the ledge and even forward air. Beef loves that ledge hop forward air onto the plat. And I feel like it's not perfect, but he doesn't get punished for it as often as he maybe should. So we'll see how that plays out. He's going up four stocks to two.
Yeah, getting a little bit of a freebie there from Mustacher. And Beef just still so zoned in.
Yeah. Oh,
okay.
Big opening.
Oh, the dash attack. Not opting to grab there. And there's that up air we were talking about, and it's paying off for Mustacher that time.
Tosses him, though. Trying to get one step closer to even.
I don't like that situation from Mustacher there, but still making it back on stage.
Has his jump. Yeah, opts to go low.
Yeah, Beef hasn't really been covering that yet, so really nothing lost going for it. Oh, and the weak back here, not converting off of it.
Yeah, low percent, it's going to be pretty negative on hit, and it's going to put you in a bad spot if you land in front of your opponent.
Ooh, the dash attack tech chase. If only there was a little less lag on that. And Mustacher opting to go to ledge, probably betting that Beef would do the same. Beef smart just to go on stage, though.
Ooh, barely makes it.
And I like what I saw from Beef there, too. Generally, after Pika snapped to the ledge, they're eager to get back on stage. Mm-hmm. You can just kind of hold an aerial above the ledge and just catch their second jump with it.
Clanks. I don't know what it clanked with, but bad spot for Mustacher. And Beef is going to send him away with no jump. Oh, went for a risky reverse. Oh, that did no hit stun at zero.
Yeah, generally that reverse up smash can work out because the back end of the hit will just pop him up for back air setup.
But if they're sweet spot on the ledge, it's much tighter window, I think, to catch him with that back hit.
Yeah, and I think that's more so props to Mustacher just having such great up Bs that we've
seen
so far.
His angles are really good. Yeah, I was going to say that. He's made a lot of stuff work that a lot of Pikas wouldn't.
Yeah, and like, you know, and those are definitely what he needs to stay in this game because I think Beef is just a little more familiar with this matchup. So Musashi's going to have to give himself like as many chances as possible.
Right. But I think Mustacher had a much better showing towards the end of the game.
Yeah.
I'm excited to see what he changes up, goes into game two.
Definitely a little more composed, I think. He kind of had a strong start and a strong finish. Just not much else going on in between. Thinking of a character switch here.
Yeah, I don't think that's what he needs. I think he can do it.
Yeah.
With this character right here. The
probably
best in the
game.
Probably
taking a minute then.
Yeah.
You know, we do have, I believe, it's like 30 seconds between coaching.
Okay.
So you can use that time to just like take your, you know, icon or take your, you know, token off the icon, the character.
Right.
Just take a minute to yourself. Think about the matchup. Go into it with a fresh, fresh state of mind. Oh, great defensive up air right there, just falling down.
It's like such a bad feeling when you get stuck in jab with Pika, because then you just want to jab grab or something, and then you're using R to try to grab, and then it just does more jabs, and you're like, well, here we are. One of us has got to do something about it.
Yeah, and like, you know, it's like you're in too deep at that point. You're just like well, I guess I'll just keep jabbing.
You're like, maybe it'll work. Sometimes it does. Like, rare occasions by the ledge, you're like, oh, yeah, I meant to do this.
I mean, like, considering that situation, he really wasn't punished too hard for it.
Yeah,
so.
That's true.
it pays off sometimes.
Losing his first stock, but got a decent amount of percent on Beef. Beef will be at back throw percent at most of the stage.
Oh, and that was a great conversion there. The downer's a super quick flat drop there, and then we saw it again.
Yeah.
Going for a pivot up tilt there, I think.
Beef going a little crazy, but Mustacher cannot close it out. But there's a back throw, and that'll do it. Ate a little bit of percent for his trouble, but we'll see how he can make it work. He's moving a little bit better, but Beef is just one step ahead in almost every scenario.
Here's up back air.
We'll do it.
Stock there, yeah.
Pretty fresh. Killed at 99.
And a good quick conversion from Mustacher there, just to put Beef off stage.
Oh, I like it.
Yeah. That was good awareness from Mustacher, just picking up where Beef was going to fly after that there. Mustacher doesn't really need much to get the kill here.
There's those jabs, but on the other side this
paying
time.
Paying off for Beef, getting out of a pretty bad situation there. I like that he opted to roll out of it.
Oh, got caught slipping.
Yep.
Another amazing
jumps here.
Yep. You really gotta respect peak up tilt in every single matchup.
Yeah, especially when you're kind of using your double jump to approach.
Right.
It just becomes a lot riskier.
A disjointed fast anti-air is something to always fear.
And Beef not only getting back to stage, but getting a little bit of chip damage as well. You know, at 140%, you just want to make every hit count here, just to make your last two stocks a little easier.
All right, bringing it down to a one stock deficit, only at 10%. Let's see what he can do. Risky get up attack. Beef not getting much off of it, but that up smash at low percent is going to be negative, and Beef gets a punish. Eats the hit. Oh, okay.
The defensive forward smash on top flat.
Totally on purpose. Oh, can't find his angle that time. His luck has run out. And Beef is going to take it with a 2-0, holding down for the Midwest.
Mm-hmm.